Hey guys, welcome back to my organic farm. It's been a really long time, and over the past actually a year or so, there's been a lot of growth. My pomegranate tree has grown pretty big now. My avocado tree has also grown pretty large. In fact, my pomegranate tree is now started fruiting. We've got quite a few harvests from it. You can see there's a flower here, and the fruit has just started growing, and they grow really big, and it's been really good. Out there, you can see my mango tree. It's grown really fine and good, and I think we should be getting our first harvest next summer in 2017. So it should be really good. Anyway, so today what I wanted to show you guys was about how to do composting. So I did put up a video about a year and a half ago on how to do vermicomposting, but a lot of y'all expressed concerns of not being able to find worms, or just felt a bit queasy when it came to handling these worms. So a lot of you had asked for a method of just doing composting without the worms. So that is what I wanted to do today. And I also feel that this is a very important matter that we have to take up, and one that is of very pressing concern, considering the amount of waste management issues that we're having in our country. We've already seen the Mandur crisis that took place in Bangalore and Delhi running out of space for its landfills. And one of the major reasons for this is that the wet waste that is produced in our homes is filling up these landfills and taking up space where the non-recyclable waste would be placed. So it would make more sense for us to try and compost this wet waste, which is biodegradable, than to have it go into the landfills and take up space that could otherwise be used for non-biodegradable waste. So today I'm going to be showing you guys a special method of composting known as pipe composting. So let's just go and have a look at what we need. Okay, so this here is what is called the pipe composting. This is what we'll be using as the tool for it. And you can see that a lot of them have been placed in and around in my farm that I've been using actually for the past year to year and a half. And one of the major advantages of this type of composting is that once it goes into the soil, as you throw in your waste, it gets converted into compost and it gets sent through these holes into a large part of land, which means that you don't need to scoop out the compost once again and then apply it. So it's very useful in that method. So what we need is a pipe. This here is, I think, a PVC pipe, and I've put a few holes at the bottom. This is basically the part of the pipe that will go below the soil. So these holes are basically to allow the compost, all the extra water and the minerals to flow out into the sand once we put the waste in. And over here I've just got a selection of the general everyday waste that we would find coming in from our homes. Everything from dried leaves from the garden to some vegetable peels, rotten vegetables, puja flowers, coffee powder, eggshells, etc. etc. So what we first will be doing is that we take the pot, we take the pipe, and we need to create a hole of a sort inside the ground where we can position this pipe. And so I'll just be placing this pipe inside the soil now. We'll be putting all the soil in. Make sure that you place as much soil and put it in as rigidly as possible so that it doesn't fall or sag in any way to the end. Also, some of y'all may have noticed that I'm working on what is called a raised bed. This is a type of method of agriculture where I would just call it like a really large pot, and it's really useful in larger gardens where you have more space. So the advantage is that you have a lot more control over the soil that you grow, over the soil that you used to grow, because you can constantly change it, you can add manure, vermicompost, compost easily. And the other advantage is that you use a lot less water in this method of agriculture. So it's very useful during the summer months, and that is when these things are actually really used. They're very useful then, because you could grow a lot of different vegetables that are enough to feed the needs of one family. So this is something that I will show you guys in the coming video. Yeah, so this is the pipe that I've just put in. As you can see, the holes are all below the soil. So that is basically so that all the nutrients, like I said, go back down into the soil. So now we'll be taking our waste. I'll first take the dried leaves from my garden. and I'll be putting them in. In fact, to make it easier, you could probably use a larger pipe. I'm using a relatively small pipe. You could also probably put in a taller pipe so that if you don't have too much space for multiple pipes, you could just use one so that you get the compost at the bottom by the time it's done filling up, by the time you're done filling up the entire pipe. So this method of the pipe composting that I'm doing is one that is being done without the worms. In most people who do the pipe composting actually do it using the worms, and these aren't really the earthworms that are used for this type of composting. It's actually maggots that are used to feed on the soil. But this is going to be done without that, and it'll be a lot easier for people who are not very comfortable with using the worms. I'll just put in my coffee. These are some old vegetable peels, some rotten vegetables, and again some peels. This is the eggshells, and these are some flowers from a puja that you could also put in. So you just put those in and just put like a layer of soil above that, so that it doesn't smell in any way, release any odors. It hastens the process of the composting. Just make sure that it covers the entire top. So that's about it. That's the first layer of compost that we put into these pipes. And the thing is that you can put multiple number of these pipes all around in your garden. Thing is, since I have a lot of space, I've put up multiple pipes all over. But you could even put in two or three pipes in the same amount of land. So once you're done with putting your compost in, you pour a little bit of water. Not too much, otherwise it'll rot and it'll start stinking. So and what you do is you take the a tile or any sort of covering, and you put it over the pot so that the first thing is it prevents any excess rainwater from entering inside. Second thing is it prevents the excess odor from coming out, and then it also prevents birds and rodents and stuff from getting in and then creating a mess out of everything. So that is the reason why we put the covering over these pipes. And this method can be used, you could put in your compost every day. I think it takes about a week for a pipe of this size to fill up at my house. So it should probably last about a week and a half to 2 weeks for you. When you move on to the next one, and it takes about 6 to 8 weeks for this compost to mature and becomes fine and so that you could use it again, and then you could start using it. So I feel that this method is something that is very sustainable and could be used and is also contributing to the plants around it. So it's a really great method of composting, and I hope you guys try it out. Thank you very much. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel.